Hi, welcome to CS On Air in association with Women Tech Makers. Apologies for starting a little bit late, we had a few technical issues there. This is the first in a series of informal interviews with Google engineers to learn what motivated them to enter the field of computer science and what excites them about it today. I'm pleased that we've got Beryl Nelson joining us today from the Krakow office in Poland. And we've also got Lynette Webb here from the London office. So Beryl, just to start off with, can you tell us a little bit about your role at Google and your career in engineering in general?
Sure, thanks for hosting me as well. I'm currently working on a team that builds infrastructure that is used to power basically everything that happens at Google. Just prior to this, until very recently, I was working on a team that has the search backend. So this was really, really rewarding because everybody I know would type in Google searches, and I was part of working on that. My role as an engineering manager means that I have to be an engineer who also is able to manage people. And managing people in this case means making sure that people are motivated and that we get the best ideas out of everyone to get great impact results. It doesn't mean telling people what to do at all. It's quite the contrary. It's getting the best out of everyone because we have a lot of talented engineers. Now, my path into computing was not straight. I originally studied mathematics, but I came into computing because after my master's, which was in genetic biochemistry, I was invited into a symbolic computation lab. I worked many years in languages. I took about 7 years off when we moved to Japan when my twins were small, and then I worked on a project that was doing an automatic integrated circuit tester for image sensor chips, the kinds of chips you'd use in your cell phone camera. I've worked in a lot of different kinds of applications, but having a good grounding in basic fundamentals makes it possible for you to move from one subject to another. It's really fun and interesting. So I should say when I was hired at Google, I was living in India. I lived in India for 6.5 years also.
Cool. What for you was really the hook that kind of got you started in computer science, that kind of really grabbed you as seeing this as something that you'd love to do?
Well, as I said, I studied mathematics, but my father is an electrical engineer, and he said, I think you'd like being an engineer. So I took some classes partly to make him feel better, right? But one of those was a computer science class that was taught by Joe Weizenbaum. Joe Weizenbaum was a visionary. He built this really amazing artificial intelligence program before we had the term artificial intelligence practically. It was very simple. It just would answer questions and permute some of your words in like a psychoanalyst would. And it turned to be really effective. People personified the computer. This was a man who could really inspire you. So because I really enjoyed that, even though I studied mathematics and biology, I took other courses. So what I found really motivating for me is that the kinds of problems you can solve really are fun and interesting and exciting. Sometimes when I was working in languages, they reminded me of the mathematics kinds of problems that I liked when we were solving not just a problem, but doing these formal proofs. And I like the fact that we're building things that we can use because I feel that I'm a maker. Like one of my hobbies is that at the moment in our summer vacations, I and my twin daughters are building instruments at a violin workshop in Cambridge. So my twins are building twin violins and I'm building a viola. I've built the kids a dollhouse, I've made them dolls. When I was young, I did a lot of clothing and cooking and various kinds of needlepoint. I think there's a lot of analogy between what an artist thinks about creating a physical object that's kind of an expression and the way that a good computer scientist or programmer thinks about the way that they create the kinds of programs that solve really interesting problems. The most exciting problems I've solved, I would say, is one is the first version of Common Lisp, which was the first standardization attempt at the language Lisp. Another one was a job before Google. I was working on a project to get truth in healthcare data, which is a very, very hard problem, but ethically very sound. Working in Google search, everybody knows what you're doing, right? But interestingly, although many people like applications that you can put on a mobile phone and things where you can see it, I really like the underlying infrastructure. I find the kinds of problems that you solve that are close to the machine are really interesting and satisfying for me.
Cool. Why do you think computer science is such a good thing to study and potentially such a great option for a career?
There are two reasons, I think, that are primarily active right now, at least in my mind. One is that you can apply computer science and programming techniques to solve many kinds of problems. So, for example, my older daughter just finished a master's in cognitive neuroscience, and she did her field work in Namibia studying dolphin behavior. To write up her thesis and some papers, she had to do some sophisticated analysis on some of the data that they collected. And she had to learn some programming in R to do some statistical analysis for this. There's so many kinds of problems to which you can solve computing. You can apply computing techniques to help you generate interesting analyses. You see it in studies of social science. You see it in building construction. You see it in simulating disease control. There's so many problems you can apply it to. Now, the second reason I think it's a really nice field to be in is that it's wide open in the sense that there's so many opportunities right now that it gives you a lot of flexibility in your life. I've lived in 5 countries and I've worked in 4. And in part, this is because having some good fundamentals, I can try out new areas and get jobs in interesting places. And in a more strictly defined field, it can be more difficult to get that flexibility to have a really varying life.
So, Beryl, what's your advice for someone at school today who's thinking about pursuing a career in computer science? How do they work out if it's something that they would be good at and be interested in?
That's a really good question, because there are a lot of ways into computer science, actually, and some computer scientists, like myself, didn't actually start by saying, I'm going to be a computer scientist. Some people prefer to get involved in programming early, and that is a valid way to start. You can try to solve problems that you're particularly interested in using programming tools, and there are lots of languages and platforms available for beginners and for more advanced users these days. But programming is something that you can do without actually studying formal computer science, and studying more formally kinds of algorithms you can use and so on can give you a lot more power. It gives you a basis on which you can scale more deeply. So in order to be successful, you have to be really motivated. You really need to love the problem you're trying to solve. And it's really important to find people who can mentor you, can work with you to help you learn how to solve this problem, because there's so many different ways you can solve any particular problem. It's much easier to learn if you have a community around you of people who are also interested in that problem. And that's one of the things I really like about my career. I work with really interesting people who are intelligent and motivated, and we can work together to solve interesting and hard problems.
Cool. And just one last question. You mentioned that you've got twin daughters, I think, and you know that's no easy feat bringing up twins. But how have you managed to sort of juggle your career in computing with raising a family?
Well, there are many ways to do this. I have 3 daughters. My older one is the one who just finished the master's, and she's starting a PhD this week in neurophysiology in Düsseldorf. and the twins are 17. The most important thing to do when you're thinking about having a family is choose your partner wisely, right? The kind of support you get at home makes all the difference in deciding what kinds of things you can do. Now, the way that we managed is that my husband is academic, also in computer science, and I'm in industry. When my older daughter was born, I went to half-time work, but we basically never saw each other. One of us was always home with the child, right? And when my twins were born, we continued that kind of model. But when we moved to Japan, I just quit totally. My twins were babies, and the older one was 5. I took time off from work altogether. When the twins were in first grade, I was invited into a company. I worked part-time. In India, I had a number of different models. I worked full-time in companies. I had a job. I was working from home. So I've done many of the kinds of things that you can think of. Leaving work and coming back, part-time work, working from home. And there are advantages to all of them. The most important thing is that you and your partner are able to agree on what kinds of risks you're willing to take and what to invest in.
Wow. Thanks very much, Beryl. And it's good to hear that it's been a, you know, CS has led you to also sort of a flexible job. Thanks very much for joining us today, Beryl and Lynette as well are in London, and for all those who have joined the broadcast. If you want to find out more about the Women Tech Makers series, you can go to developers.google.com/women-techmakers. And we'll be back next week with another interview with Mandy Waite, who's a developer advocate in London. And all of those details will be advertised on the G+ Google in Education page. Okay, so thanks very much. Have a great afternoon, Beryl and Lynette.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye.